Hi friends, welcome to ourcoaching.com. My name is Venkatesh Kolipaka and I am a registered tutor with ourcoaching.com. In this session, we are going to discuss about history of Java and its introduction. Java is a programming language which is having the core component as a object-oriented programming. That is OOPS concept, you can say that. Actually, Java is a simple programming language and it is started developing in Sun Microsystems in 1991. Here we can see the photographs of James Gosling, Patrick Norton and Mike Sheridan who were initiated the Java language project. And initially the Java language project developed Sun Microsystems as I said and released its first version in 1995. The Time magazine called Java as one of the 10 best products in 1985. Originally, Java developed for small and embedded systems in electronic appliances like set-up boxes. Firstly, it was called as Green Dog and later it's called as Oak. Oak means is the symbol of strength, that's why they call as Oak. In 1995, Oak was renamed as Java because the Oak is already a trademark by Oak Technologies. Before putting the name to the programming language as Java, the team gathered some names like Silk, Jolt, DNA, Dynamic and Java. Finally, they came up with the name Java. Actually, Java is an island where the coffee is first produced. And then the coffee is called as Java coffee. Inside here, we can see the Java version released till now. The current stable release is Java CTN, and here there are 12 releases there from 1995 to 2018. Now we'll see why Java is that much importance because of these features of the Java. Well, if you look into features of Java, Java is platform independent and object oriented program, secure and multi-threading, and portable and simple. You can say why we are saying that the platform is independent. Java is a platform independent because we look into the internal of the program execution. When the programmer writes the code will be compiled by the compiler and the compiler will generate byte code and it will generate a dot class file. The dot class file will be executed on any JVM. Means if you write in one system with one operating system, in one machine, it will be run on any other system with any operating system. So we can call that if you write any program in Java, the program can be run on any other machine. Like that is why we are calling the Java programming language as platform independent. But the JVM is platform dependent. And one more thing, the core concept of the Java is based on the object-oriented language. Actually, object-oriented language has consist A language can be called as object-oriented programming language if the language follows the inheritance, encapsulation, polymorphism, and abstraction. So the Java is following these core concepts. So we can call as object-oriented programming language. It is secure language because we are not using any pointers here, and we are using multi-threading and portable because it's portable because we are writing on any machine and the code which is in bytecode can be run on any other machine, so we can say that it is portable. And Java language is very simple and it has taken some of the syntaxes from the C language, we can say, and it's very similar to the C language and it is avoided some concepts like pointers to make it simple. And Java also have correction framework which will have inbuilt methods which reduce the length of the code, unlike in C language. Before going in deep in Java, let us discuss about the Java terminology we are using regularly. That is JVM, JRE and JDK. JVM is nothing but Java Virtual Machine and JRE is nothing but Java Runtime Environment. JDK is nothing but Java Development Kit. Here JVM is nothing but Java virtual machine, and it is like it will interrupt the Java bytecode which is generated by the compiler, which is nothing but the dot plus 5. And also it will take the responsibility to allocate the memory for the variables, methods and objects for a class of JRE, Java Runtime Environment, also known as Java Runtime. It's a part of Java Development Kit. Java Runtime Environment provides the requirements such as core classes, supporting library for existing a Java application. Java Runtime Environment provides the requirements such as core classes, supporting library file for executing a Java application. This is a runtime environment where our programs will be executed. JDK, Java Development Kit. It is a program development environment for writing Java applications like web applications and desktop applications. It consists of runtime environment, JRE, and it sits on the top of the operating system layer. JDK is a combination of JVM and JRE and some other core libraries. Now let us create and execute one simple Java program. Let's see how to create and execute a simple Java program. I'm clicking on a package. Take right click and click on new. Then click on class. Here I'm giving the class name first Java program. I'm selecting the class as public static void main which will contain. And I'm asking to generate comments. And click on finish. As everyone just remember these steps, we will see how to create a application clearly in the next upcoming sessions. Now this is a code which is generated automatically by the JVM. Here we having the class name as first Java program, which is a class and which is public. We will see the keywords later. Upcoming sessions. Here we are having the main method. This is the main method. So we'll write some simple code. I'm writing system.autoprintln. I'm simply printing something like welcome to. Java world. I'm saving this. I'm click on run button which is here. So we can see the output in the console saying that welcome to Java world. So here we are write a simple program and execute it. And we got the output in the console saying that welcome to Java world. Now we'll do some more modifications to the program. I'm taking a string variable, string name is equal string name, and then I'm just initialize the name is equal to. I'm taking a string variable, and I'm assigning a string to that Venkatesh Kolipaka. And I'm printing this one. Click on save button, and as you know, click on this run icon. We can see the output in the console saying that welcome to Java world Venkatesh Kolipaka, which we are printing here. Here we can see that I simply take a variable saying name, which is type of string. This is called initialization. initialization. And here for the string name we are assigning a value saying Venkatesh Kulipaka, and this will, it can be said that assigning, we are simply assigning a value this, we are simply assigning a value to the variable. So, and we are here printing that. So you can say that here, what is this? This is a variable. Now we will discuss actually what is a variable.